presentation, Advanced HTML XBlock for Open EDX.
Very good evening to everyone. I am Srinan Rai Chaudhary from Content Team, and this is Pravalika, and that is Ashutosh. And our project was titled Advanced HTML XBlock for the Open EDX platform. So I will be taking you through the first part of our presentation, where I'll be talking about the platform that we worked on and the limitations of the current HTML component in the platform. So what is OpenEDX? So OpenEDX is basically an open source MOOC platform which was developed by professionals at MIT and Harvard. The centerpiece of the OpenEDX architecture is the edX platform, which consists of the LMS and the CMS. Students take their courses through the LMS, and the CMS is for the course content to create their courses and publish it. And also some of the notable features in edX is that the courses are created using modules which are called XBlocks. And the courses can be imported and exported without touching the content itself and keeping all the course settings intact. Secondly, there are also many other components of OpenEDX, which includes notes, catalogs, analytics, etc., and many more. In short, we can call edX platform as a XBlock runtime because it's an application which hosts XBlocks. Moving on, what are basically XBlocks? XBlocks are the basic component architecture of OpenEDX. They are specific units which provide a definite functionality to both the learners and the users. XBlocks can be anything ranging from an image, a video, a web page, or even a small paragraph of text. In the present, there are many already implemented XBlocks in the OpenEDX platform, like the HTML editor, then video component, the interactive questions, etc. Now, talking about XBlocks, we must also mention their precursors, which are XModules. So XModules was the initial component design in the OpenEDX architecture, but now almost every XBlock is being XModule is being replaced by XBlocks because XBlocks give us more flexibility and more scalability because any third-party developer can develop an XBlock and integrate it very easily with OpenEDX platform. So this is the basic difference which we referenced from a Google group discussion, that XBlocks is the newer API and XModule was the first component design and is still in OpenEDX, but had limitations, so XBlocks better designed to support third-party developers to extend the OpenEDX platform. Next, we will be talking about the HTML components in OpenEDX through which course creators create courses. So basically, there are two editing interfaces. One is the raw editor and one is the visual editor. The visual editor is basically a word processing-like environment where you can edit add text and without having to code in HTML. And the raw HTML editor helps us to directly mark up our content in HTML and view them. The templates provided are text, announcement, iframe tool, and raw HTML editor. So, and the editors that are currently being implemented in OpenEDX are as follows. TinyMC is the visual or the WYSIWYG editor, that is what you see, what you get. CodeMirror is the raw HTML editor for TinyMC. WND is an editor which is used in discussion forums and emails, and the current versions are as follows. TinyMC is 4.0.20, CodeMirror is 3.27, and WND version is not exactly unknown, as edX just forked the code in 2012. Next, we will talk about the issues that limitations, we should rather say, of the current HTML components. These are the screenshots. The first screenshot is taken from the raw HTML editor. It's taken from an instance of the IIT Bombay X server provided to us for testing. So first thing to notice here is that there is no code indentation. So all the code is cramped in a single place. Secondly, the features like code folding is absent. So these are the two main limitations. And also now, suppose we want to add our custom style, as we did there, which is properly indented. And so this should be rendered as internal HTML, internal CSS, and produce the desired effect. But as soon as we press OK, the CSS gets spilled all over the web page. So there is no isolation between our HTML component and the whole web page. The CSS gets applied everywhere. Secondly, so this is a limitation that internal CSS is not supported presently in the raw HTML. Only inline CSS is supported. Secondly, when we try to re-edit it, we can see, first of all, our indentation is lost. And secondly, TinyMC has weirdly commented our style tag, and it's not visible anymore. So this is one of the issues. And this, if you publish the course, the similar effect is shown in the LMS. This is the LMS where the student sees this. So it's the same effect. So why does this happen? Well, XBlocks are mainly displayed in our course in a web page using XBlock fragments, which contain all the resources needed to display the XBlocks, such as HTML, JavaScript, and CSS. So currently, there is no isolation between our XBlocks contents and the web page. Suppose we consider the whole web page as an UI, which contains its own internal CSS, internal JS. And when we add our own style tag inside the XBlock, it gets automatically concatenated to the internal CSS of the web page using this fragment. So this fragment API can isolate between two fragments and thus produces the effect as shown. So based on these limitations, our main objectives were as follows: to improvise the present raw HTML editor so that it includes these three features, first was page indentation, first was code folding, and secondly was auto completion of text. Second was full support of internal CSS, then full support of all the HTML and HTML5 tags, because presently there are many tags which are not working very well in the raw HTML editor. Secondly was fixing the cursor placement issue, and next was supporting JavaScript. So I will now hand over to Pravalika. We will explain the solutions and the approaches we took.
Basing on the objectives, we have to clear our objectives. Working on our objectives, we have come to some conclusions. Like, we have observed some things. The first thing is the editors which are being used in the OpenEdX have been stopped. Like, they were not updated from the August 2016. So if we include the latest versions of the code mirror and TinyMC editors, were Code Mirror has got the editor of version of 5.38.0. So while updating these editors, some of our objectives like code folding, indentation, and autocomplete will be achieved. And the second thing is, we have found that the TinyMC, a plugin for TinyMC is found in Code Mirror. Like, the TinyMC has a Code Mirror plugin, which will merge both the VCBIG editor as well as the raw HTML editor. And the plugin which is being used will take any version of TinyMC, which is 4.xxx. And the working of both the raw HTML editor as well as the visual editor is based on this X module, which is html.modulepy, and which handles all the operations of the HTML editor. So basing on these observations, we have come up to two approaches, which our first approach is updating both the editors so that some of our major objectives will be achieved. And in this, we have even we've chose this approach compared to our second approach is integrating a third party open source editor into an OpenEdX platform, like Brackets or Notepad++ or content tools, which have got much better features compared to the present versions of TinyMC and Code Mirror, which are being used in the present current version of OpenEdX. But we have chose the approach one because in approach one, completely upgrading something is much better, easier compared to integrating a completely from a new thing. And as well as in approach one, we have used iframes for the CSS part, for the internal CSS, where these iframes will be accessing, these iframes are used for accessing even the bootstrap thing, which will be beautifying the course content much more. Initial approaches, so basing on the approach one, initial approaches for supporting internal CSS, wrapping the complete HTML content in an iframe, setting the width of the iframe to 100% and height equal to the height of the content of the frame, and setting the border of the iframe to 0. By doing this, we have achieved an invisible iframe which will be loading all our HTML content. Our second approach for achieving internal CSS was using JavaScript. Here we have separated the CSS and the HTML content and wrapped the complete HTML content into a div tag by giving it with a unique ID, and later calling each and every unique ID and entering styles to it. But we have chosen the first approach of CSS because due to this, even we could even include bootstrap, as well as while including an iframe, any tool, there's no merging of two blocks of CSS in the LMS of Studio. So the first approach, the local integration, it includes first we need to download both the versions of the TinyMC as well as the Code Mirror into our local system and integrate both of them. Here, to integrate the code mirror for TinyMCE plugin and code, we have to integrate code mirror for TinyMCE plugin in the TinyMCE init.tinymc page, and then test this hybrid editor, and then integrate this editor with the Django, because edX uses Django as its backend, and test the Django integration. What we have found out after our local integration was most of the HTML tags and the attributes worked. Like all we have checked complete HTML5, all the attributes, elements, tags, as well as we have checked the CSS and Bootstrap too, and everything worked pretty fine. And most of the CSS styles and attributes even worked. And CSS animation and external CSS such as Bootstrap works. And the complete link of all the testings which we have done have been in this on link one, which we have even provided in our link on our source code and in our report. And the source code for the integration of both the two editors is even provided in the link two, where it is even provided in our report. And wrapping the content, complete in CSS to enable CSS, internal CSS, we have wrapped the complete content in an iframe, which is even given in link two. And the second phase of the first approach is the OpenEdX integration. So for OpenEdX integration, we have to install an instance of OpenEdX on a local system. We have used DevStack for a project, since it is most suited for the developers. For the DevStack thing, we had even installed some virtual environment. We needed a virtual environment. For that, we have used Docker. And in the basic starting stages, we have issues with Docker, like proxy issues. And installing Docker was a bit tough because we have skipped some steps in the between. But we have to be careful that each and every step of Docker initialization should be taken. And later, add the latest version of Code Mirror 5.3.8 to the source code of OpenEdX, leaving the old version untouched. We have not touched the old version, which is the same, that 5.0. And we have just included our editor version, which we have Now we have configured the TinyMCE to open the updated version of Code Mirror. Here we have changed, we have included the Code Mirror plugin in edit.js file. And later the results, which after OpenEdX integration, we have found some results. There were TinyMCE open as an instance of Code Mirror, the latest version in its raw HTML editor. And later that features such as code folding and indentation works pretty fine. But we had small issues with this. Those were that the effect of the internal CSS was only visible inside the WYSIWYG editor. Like only the code mirror part, only the TinyMCE editor works fine. Like our effects were not seen in the LMS part. Once we have save or progress the OpenEdX backend, automatically it removes the style tag. Like once we have added a style tag, the complete style tag is being removed by the OpenEdX backend. So we had issues, so we had to change our approach, which will be told by Ashutosh.
Okay, so because of these hurdles, we tried to research a lot. We again faced some hurdles because of which we had to change our approach. So while we were changing approach, we had this idea, we were reading about OpenEdX more and more, and we came across the idea of XBlocks. So what we thought was, we can develop whatever we have done till now into a standalone XBlock, which will be even a better approach. So I'll explain how it was a better approach. So it's basically a standard way of extending OpenEdX platform. It is one of the standard ways of extending OpenEdX platform. They can be installed pretty easily and also uninstalled pretty easily. So it's not a load on system at all. The XBlocks are optional. So if someone does not want our advanced HTML editor like code folding, nice styles, nice JavaScript, they can use the current HTML editor and be fine with it. And lastly, that was our first approach that caused our first approach to fail. It keeps the OpenEdX source code intact. So even if our XBlock fails, OpenEdX system does not fail. So that was the biggest advantage. Now we'll just go through the features of our
advanced HTML editor. So we completely support CSS. We support all CSS attributes, including animations, and we can also include external CSS through a link. Then we have JavaScript support. The JavaScript support is fairly secure. It does not allow you to redirect you to another sites and all. We have taken care of it. Then it supports all HTML and HTML5 tags. Previously, audio tags and video tags were not working. They are working fine now in our X block. And all the editor is on steroids now. It's completely like Sublime Text and all. You'll feel good. So we'll just quickly see how our X block can be used to create interactive courses. We have a demo video. So this is a demo course about CSS animations. So as we can see, we can have really interactive and really good looking course by using our X block. See those. Okay, so the source, we can see the source code right over there, and the live action of CSS animation right below. So students will be able to understand much better. And also the course content creator won't have to stylize that color highlighting won't, he can just use highlight.js for the source code indent, source code highlighting. So that was not possible before. Now JavaScript is supported, so he can just load highlight.js from CDN and he can use it very well. Or if he has some his own JavaScript or CSS library, then he can upload that CSS and JavaScript to files and upload section in OpenEdX course, and then he'll get the link and he can use that as well. Now we'll see how this works. So every X block has a student view and a studio view. Student view is what is shown to students in LMS, and studio view is what is shown to course creator when he clicks on edit. So studio view is fairly simple. It's just a instance of code mirror 5.38.0 with a live preview panel. We'll see it in further slides. But student view is somewhat different from traditional. So it's an iframe. In a nutshell, it's an iframe. It has a unique ID. And because of this unique ID, you can include as much as blocks in your course on same page. They'll load just fine. It has invisible borders. So you won't be able to recognize that this is a iframe or its actual content. So it's a good user experience. And secure JavaScript. So when we are using iframes, there was a biggest security concern ki if some course content creator accessed window.top, then he can literally modify the system, modify that page any way he wants. So we have sandboxed it, and we have prevented window.top access to anyone in that iframe. So all the iframe and CSS is limited to iframe itself. So now we'll see how it looks in studio. So whenever you add our X block, this is the default content that you'll get. And it's the same gradient background, gradient animating background that we saw in LMS. When you click on edit, this is where the studio view comes in. So on the left hand side, we have our editor with a nicely indented code, automatic indentation. And you can also see code folding gutters. I'm not exactly sure if they're visible. Okay, they're there. And on the right hand side, you have a live preview panel. So whatever changes you do in editor, or you can see live preview, you can live preview them in live preview panel. So coming to settings tab, we provide basic settings. You can change the display name. Also, if you don't want live preview panel and you want a full width code editor, then you can disable the live preview panel and you'll have a full width code editor like this. So it's nice for editing purposes. Then this is actually live preview in action. So I've edited a couple of things there and they have reflected instantly in the live preview panel. And obviously after saving, you can see the contents in studio as well. So coming to future work, we are looking for a more autocompleteness in our editor. So right now, our editor can autocomplete tags. So if you open a tag, let's say A tag, and then close it, then it will automatically indent the code inside it properly, a nice way. Obviously, you can undo it if you don't want. But so we are focusing on autocompleteness. Like, let's say you are typing a CSS property called background color, and you type background, then you should have a panel showing you more background properties. Let's say background color, background transition, and stuff. And so that is autocomplete feature. Then second is setting a common CSS to entire course. So this is actually we are focusing more on. So this includes, so let's say a course content creator wants to have a common CSS to be included in each and every advanced HTML X block under single course. So what he can do is, what he should be able to do is, he should be able to upload a common.css and common.js in files and uploads, and our XBlock should be able to automatically fetch them. So that will save a lot of time for course content creators to have their layouts. They can just add text for their new units, and they'll be styled according to common.css. So we are currently researching on this. This will require Django settings and Django backend settings to be checked very nicely if XBlocks are allowed to access them, if they are global to all the XBlocks within a single course. We are still researching on that. And lastly, dark theme in editor is always appreciated. Like, for me, like, I use dark themes. Okay. So, coming to conclusion, I would say our XBlock has opened a way to a new world of interactive courses whose functionality is only limited by imagination of course creator. And lastly, I would like to thank our mentors and all the Summer Internship 2018 mentors who helped us throughout the process to have this working, have our OpenEdX system working. And lastly, I would like to thank Professor Fatak for giving us an opportunity to come here to stay at IIT Bombay for 7 weeks. Thank you.
The links that you mentioned in your presentation, I think, so one is, of course, Ashutosh B. Sate, which is okay, but that is GitHub link.
Yes.
The other one is Google Docs. Yes. Now, I am a bit concerned about Google, given that, in my opinion, Mr. Trump is a American avatar of Shiv Sena. You never know what will happen to these companies providing services all across the world and so on. So I much rather prefer a GitHub kind of thing. In any case, we should have all of these in our repository as well.
So actually, we have already committed it in our GitHub in Ashutosh account itself. So the link is present in Ashutosh.
Just the report link is on.
Complete report link.
No. That is different. I am talking about going forward. Going forward, we should have. So, for example, the OER repository that we are building. So, do you know we discovered a very interesting thing? That our video team led by Sajjan actually makes multiple versions of every video, including high resolution, low resolution, etc., and keeps that in a common directory in IIT Bombay servers, which are accessible to us. But the content team, which finally creates the .srt files with all the, what you can say, not just separators, all the basically transcripted versions, instead of saving it on the, they save it on their local machine temporarily, but upload on YouTube.
Okay.
All of them are available on YouTube.
Okay.
But again, if something was to happen to YouTube or to their services, or those services have to be, were to become costed services, what would happen to thousands of hours of recorded final versions, which are only on YouTube? So I've told the content team that when we open our OER repository, all those final versions should be available physically on the storage. I think it is unfortunate, but India may have to safeguard all these contents for our own sake later. You said that you converted to XBlock approach after doing a lot of jugglery. So roughly how much time you spent in that jugglery to understand that this is difficult, that is difficult, etc.
Like exactly we started XBlock on 20 June.
On 20th June?
Yes.
So just about 15 days.
Yes.
Very good. I think that is good work. It should also tell us that XBlock approach is probably the best approach.
Yes.
You did not notice the back end eating up your content like in the other case. It is working, your XBlock is working.
Yes, sir, it's working.
So somehow you have made yourselves immune to the back end of edX.
So XBlock is platform independent, so they can
be. I know.
To Hawthorne. From Ginkgo to Hawthorne are forward also. In the first approach, we were planning to integrate the whole advanced thing into the current HTML editor. But then it would have been a problem.
No.
This is the best approach because if the...
Thank you.